So good morning dear students, myself Dr. Lingaraju, assistant professor, department of physics, government facility college Tumkuru. Our college is affiliated to Tumkuru University. Yes, so in the fluid concept, so last class we discussed surface tension. So continuation of surface tension, today we discuss excess pressure and their applications. So this fluid concept comes in physics BSc 4th semester session number 23. So here the fluid is in the concept we are going to discuss excess pressure. So how many types of excess pressures are there? Here we know in PUC only we discussed some types of excess pressures, that is cohesive force and adhesive force. So what are their attractive forces between molecules of the same type are called cohesive. Attractive forces between molecules of the same type are called cohesive force. So example, H2H2 in water molecule, in glass tube, mercury in mercury placed in glass tube. So these two are the cohesive force examples. So second one is attractive forces between molecules of a different types are called adhesive force. So it means example is H2O plus glass in water molecule in glass tube, Hg glass in mercury placed in a glass tubes. This is called as adhesive force. So in the diagram we can observe, you see water, mercury, this is water, this mercury in this tube. So water and glass in this tube. So this is water and water, this is mercury and mercury, this is water and glass. So like that adhesive force and cohesive force are made, have a in one system or in one excess pressure. So now here we come to the based on this one excess pressure. It is known that similar molecules of a liquid attract each other by a force of cohesion and force of surface tension. It is known as that similar molecules of a liquid attract each other by a force of cohesion and force of surface tension tangentially to the liquid surfaces at rest. Tangentially liquid surfaces at the rest. So this is excess force. Next concept, next excess forces is, if the liquid meniscus is horizontal, there is no net force normal to the surface on the molecules lying on the upper surface as shown in the figure. Okay, so next we come to the second one. In the meniscus of the liquid is convex shape, then there is a existing net downward force due to the surface tension normal to the meniscus shown in the figure 2. We come to the third one. For a concave meniscus, there exists a net upward due to the surface tension normal to the meniscus. We can observe in the diagram 3. So these three are the excess pressure created by the surfaces of the pressure. So knowing this concept, next, due to the excess of pressure, inside the liquid drop, the free surface of the drop will be experience the net force or drag. So, you see, in this diagram, due to the excess pressure here, inside the liquid drop, the free surface of the drop will experience the net force in outward directions, due to which the drop will expand. Therefore, excess of pressure does the work is displacing. The surface and that work will be stored in the form of a potential energy. Here, the surface and that of the work will be stored in the potential energy. So, knowing this concept, we will come to the liquid drop, excess pressure inside a liquid drop. So, the force in the diagram you can observe. So, excess pressure, how it is inside the liquid drop is creating. Okay. Here, this is center. Here to here, r radius, here small increment dr. So, now here we have to assume this area. The force due to the surface tension acts normal to the surface in inward directions of the molecules of a liquid drop. Thereby, there must be exist excess pressure inside it. Let r be the radius of the drop, delta r be the increases, and its radius will be small amount due to the excess pressure. Radius will be small amount due to the excess pressure. Now here we have to calculate t. So t is equal to surface tension. We know the relations, that is w is equal to force into displacement. So force, excess force, displacement, area into increase in radius. So write it value, w is equal to p into a into delta r. P means excess pressure, area means, so it is 4 pi r square into increasing of radius means increment value, that is delta r. The increasing in the area of the drop is equal to final surface area minus initial surface area. Subtraction of initial and final surface areas. So, how much the area will be increases by the drop? So, that one is you can calculate. 4 pi of r minus delta r square, that is minus 4 pi r square. It becomes to 8 pi r delta r. So, neglecting delta r square, because the delta r is, you see, here we can observe the delta r is very small. If the square of this one means it is also minimum, more minimum value. So, neglecting the delta r square, next here, increase in the surface energy of the drop is equal to increase of the area into surface tension. That is equal to 2 pi r delta r into t. Now, delta r square na neglect mari delta r dava kanthi. Therefore, equation 1 and 2, previous one and this one too. So, for equation 1 and 2, we get p into 4 pi r square delta r is equal to 8 pi r delta r into t. So, t is equal to 2 pi by r. The remaining all these things are cancelled. 2 pi by r. So, excess pressure inside the soap bubble, how much it is created. Since a soap bubble is liquid film that has two free surfaces, so the excess pressure is given by p is equal to 2 into 2t by r, it is knowing well. So substitute this value, so get the 4t by r. Now, here, what here I want to observe, if the bubble is inside the liquid, as in the case of an air, bubble inside the water, only one surface is considered a free surface. Then the bubble is equivalent to the drop. So, knowing this concept, we are going to discuss the excess pressure inside the a cylindrical drop. Here, one free surface has infinite radius. So, the excess pressure is given by, see, liquid drop, soap bubble, cylindrical drop. Muru diagram na observe madi. Liquid drop, cylindrical drop. So, knowing this excess pressure inside the cylindrical drop, so we having a one expression, that is expression for excess pressure inside a curved liquid surface, that one is your requirement. So here we can see, this is the excess pressure here. How it is going to take place? We are going to have a curved liquid surface. Consider a small curvilinear rectangular element A, B, C, D. Consider a small curvilinear rectangular element A, B, C, D of a liquid surface. Let R1 be the radius of the curvature. R1 be the radius. Of the curve. Next is R1 be the radius of the curve for AB with the center at O, and R2 be the radius of the curvature of the curve B and C. B and C. Okay. With the center of O2, both O1 and O2, but both O1 and O2 are at the same side. Same surface. And therefore, the curved surface is called syncelastic surface. The curved surface is we called as a syncelastic surface. Let P, here one more is there, that is P. Let P is be the excess pressure. P is the excess pressure inside the surface. Then the outward thrust on the surface is ABCD. ABCD. So that is the excess pressure. P into surface area of ABCD. P into AB into BC. AB into BC. Let us move surface outward by the small distance. Surface outward with the small distance, that is dx. Let the new position of the surface be excess pressure, that is PQRS. So after knowing that a PQRS, the work is done, this is given by P into AB into BC into DX. So, increase in surface area is equal to area of PQRS, area of ABCD. So, PQ into QR, PQ into RS, next AB into BC. So, substituting of these two values, you are getting from the a triangle of AB. O1, AB, okay, AB O1 and PQ O1, PQ O1, okay, excess pressure, AB O1, PQ O1. So, AB by PQ is equal to A ஓ ஒன் பை பி ஓ ஒன் தெரிஞ்சுக்கொண்டு ஆர் ஒன் பை ஆர் ஒன் ஆஃப் ஆர் ஒன் பிளஸ் டிஎக்ஸ் பி கியூ இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு ஏபி ஆஃப் ஆர் ஒன் பிளஸ் ஆர் டிஎக்ஸ் பை ஆர் ஒன் தட் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு ஏபி ஆஃப் ஒன் பிளஸ் டிஎக்ஸ் பை ஆர் ஒன் சிமிலர்லி கியூ ஆர் கியூ ஆர் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு பிசி ஆஃப் ஒன் பிளஸ் டிஎக்ஸ் பை ஆர் டூ நோயிங் பி கியூ அண்ட் ஆர்எஸ் யாவது எக்ஸஸ் ப்ரெஷர் டெவலப்மெண்ட் ஆகிறது பி கியூ அண்ட் ஆர்எஸ் சார் PQ and RS, calculate the value, simplify the values. AB of 1 plus DX by R1 into BC of 1 plus DX by R2. So adding of these two, here we are getting this value. How much? Increase area of surface, PQ, RS into PQ, RS value, this is final. That is AB into BC of 1 plus DX by R1 plus DX by R2. So in is this value, substitute here. AB into BC of 1 plus DX by R1 plus DX by R2 minus of AB into BC. So, take the AB into BC common 1 plus DX by R1 plus DX by R2 minus 1. So, simplify once again this one AB into BC of DX, DX common. So, the remaining thing is 1 by R1, 1 1 cancel here, 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. So, of knowing this one, equating equation 1 and 2 we have so similarly what done increase the surface area increase the surface area is equal to t into ab of bdcc 1 by r1 plus 1 by r2 so now of knowing the equation 2 equation 1 and 2 equate it we are getting a p into ab into bc into dx that is equal to t into ab into bc ds of 1 by r1 plus r2 So then P is equal to T of 1 plus R1 plus 2. So that value also we know it. So knowing this value, the spherical liquid drop, a spherical liquid drop has only one surface, male category, on a constant radius of curvature R. Then the excess pressure inside this radius is P is equal to T of 1 by R by R plus 1 by R by R of is equal to 2T. That is the case in this order. So case 2, spherical soap bubble, a bubble can be considered a sphere with a two surfaces of a same radius. That is P is equal to 4T by R. So knowing this value, so we can make it this equations in the case 3 cylindrical drop for a cylindrical drop order R1 is equal to R that is called as radius. A diagram only R1 na radius anta karibodu. Similarly R2 na infinite anta karibodu because it is having a unlimited range. Then P is equal to T of 1 by R plus 1 by R. So you see R1 plus R2 once again I will discuss. You can observe through the diagram. See R1 plus R2. So this is R1, this is R2. So how much they having a distance from here, it is we are not going to consider. It may be any amount of length. So that is we called as a infinite. So knowing this value, R2 is infinity, P is equal to T of 1 minus, sorry, 1 by R plus 1 by infinity. Then we getting P is equal to T by R. Similarly, we come to the second one. Cylindrical bubble has two surface unlike a cylindrical drop then it becomes a 2 on the it becomes to P of 2T by T so like that here we are going to calculate the surface tension of a excess pressure of a liquid drop surfaces excess pressure here we are going to discuss So these are concepts I have referred using so many different kinds of reference books, prescribed textbooks, and also university referred, university syllabus or referred textbooks. So the reference book is College Physics, Subramanyam. The next three, 4 and 5 are prescribed textbooks. I was going through these books and I have written the my own way of the notes and also PPT with using OBS audios. So it's about this flow chapter. Thank you, and all.